Hey folks, welcome to a Marvel Avengers Alliance Redux related video here on YouTube. It's just something quick that I wanted to whip up for you guys, and that is to let you know the nearly 6 month process is complete. We have the Goofy figures complete and in my hands. So if you're not familiar with what this is a community project that I led back in the late spring, early summer, and that is because a lot of people often wanted to donate money to Goofy in a Patreon-esque style thing for his work on Marvel Avengers Alliance Redux. We know that legally, to avoid any issues, we don't want money changing hands for the project. So when I interviewed Goofy in late last winter, he mentioned that one thing to do is that if you wanted to donate to him, that he had a autism-related charity that he would like you to donate to instead. Well, I wanted to run a kind of community appreciation event for him after a member of the group on Facebook had said, hey, you know, he had linked a figure that he had made. And I contacted him and I said, how much would it be if I commissioned you to do a figure? And he gave me some rough estimates and everything. I said, okay, I'm going to raise money in the community to give thanks back to Goofy and commission some figures for you. So I put up a video and some PayPal links and everything within the group, Discord, YouTube. And thanks to one very generous donation by Initials JW, and I want to really reveal the name as he may wish to be anonymous in it, but one big donation from him put us over the top for the limit that we were looking for, so I got the figures commissioned over from a guy in the Netherlands who, when they were done, he sent them out to a painter, I think in England. And then they came back to him in the Netherlands, and they've just recently hit me in the States, and I unboxed them today. Now, unfortunately, I'm going to be the bearer of slightly bad news. One of the figures, what I consider probably the second most important figure in this whole kit, got sheared off at the ankles, pretty much the weakest point in the figure, so it has become dislocated from the base. I'm going to send it to Goofy in this state to allow him to do the repair himself, as I don't want to attempt to crazy glue or gorilla glue it and then have like a big wad of chunky plastic looking glue over there and have it be unsightly. I would rather Goofy take ownership of it. This way he hopefully gets the results he's looking for. I'm disappointed because I think this is probably going to be his favorite figure in the bunch, but I would consider it probably the second most important figure in the bunch. And I think it was, I normally pull my punches on this, but I'm saddened by this process ending with this kind of devastation to one of the figures. I think it was not wrapped very well. The way that it was wrapped is that the bubble wrap ended at the ankle. So when you see one of these pictures, you'll see probably what caused it. And then it caused the force to shear through literally the Achilles heel of the figure. So here is the box that came to me today. So this has got the three figures in it, and you can see the damage on the right side, which is somewhat not surprising for a world traveling box the way that it is. But I saw that and went, oh no, that could be bad. So here are the figures with my cat for scale. There is Kingpin, there's Captain Marvel in the movie outfit, there's Spider-Man, and then there's Black Suit Spider-Man. This Spider-Man was one of Goofy's requested characters, along with potentially Gambit, and that's why I'm really sad that you can see there the little bit of white, he's cut off at the ankles because a little bit of a shearing factor must have hit that figure, and it cut him off at the ankles over there. And you can see there's the white, his feet are still there. He just kind of got clipped below the knees, but the Kingpin is absolutely marvelous. I had seen pictures of it along the way. The detail looked amazing. The paint job on this and the sculpting makes the fabric look very, very realistic. Very lifelike. I mean, these folds right over here on the elbow are phenomenal. And it's a level of detail that somebody who understands their craft knows exactly what they're doing. I mean, the ascot over here with the vest, the shading on it, this figure is absolutely phenomenal. And if this is all that we paid for, I think it would be amazing. But the original project was the Spider-Man and the Kingpin. The Captain Marvel and the black suit Spider-Man were bonuses. Just even this, like, destruction of the pavement here on the base is a very cool touch. There's Captain Marvel over there. Sadly, Spider-Man is actually very detailed. He's in a very classic pose. I just have him laying down and my cat in the background for scale. And then the black suit Spider-Man is also very cool, and his base stands out. So I'm going to pack these up tomorrow and in a much better, a better wrapping job and a safer box, and send these out to Goofy. I decided to do a video on it rather than post the pictures, because this way, if Goofy does not want to see these before he unwraps them, it's much easier to avoid. The link is going to be posted on Discord and Facebook and clearly state spoilers. Goofy don't watch this, and he can definitely have a Christmas style opening when he gets these without having the gifts spoiled. I'm very sad that Spider-Man was dealt a mortal wound over here, because these figures, and I mean, obviously you can see from my cat, they are small, but the detail and the craftsmanship that went into these is phenomenal. And I mean, to paint at the tiniest of these levels, to get darker colored bluishy white in the folds over there to match the actual folds of the arm and the elbow, and the detailing, the shading on this cracked concrete, I mean, even the face, even the shading on the face, this is really, really bang up work. I will link the video to the creator of the figures if you were somewhat interested in contacting that person, maybe to get your own stuff done along these lines. Leave a note in the video and maybe he'll be able to respond and give you the details on it. You know, if you look at that Kingpin, you're like, wow, Kingpin's one of my favorite villains. Can I get that exact Kingpin for myself? You know, he can choose to respond and let you know what it would entail, because that's basically what I did. I saw his post and I was like, I really want to do something for Goofy. I think this is a wonderful gesture from the community as to the work that he's putting in, and it's a way we can thank him without it being from our wallets and get anybody in the project in trouble. So there you go. I'm thrilled that it's done. This has been a long process. I have wanted to keep you guys informed about it the whole way through, because a lot of times you see these things on Kickstarter or donations on Patreon and everything like that, and then people just take off with the money and don't give updates, and everybody's left sad and upset they don't have their product. I mean, I'm definitely very sad that Spider-Man's laying down on the job over there. Aside from that, I'm floored at the craftsmanship that went into this, at the actual crafting level, at the painting level. I'm happy that the process is done, and when I send this out in the mail tomorrow to Goofy, that is a load off my mind, because I don't want to be the community bad guy. You might think, well, what exactly did you do? I mean, you got donations. Okay, it's really on the people who donated. Well, I donated a good amount of money for this, too. And the pressure was on me to deliver, because I didn't want to let the community down. I didn't want to take money from people and then have it be a very long process and Goofy never get the figures or them not be anywhere near the quality of what we paid for. To know that these two were done with two bonuses, they're all phenomenal. The fact that they're going in the mail tomorrow, it's going to be a complete load off my mind to say that it's done. Goofy has his community appreciation project in his hand. He's thrilled with them. He will cherish them always. And I'll be happy to put a finished sign on all of this and say that it's done. And I'm happy the community came together for this. This is... If I was Goofy and I was working through blood, sweat, and tears on my own time to what might be sometimes a thankless job of coding this game and all the hurdles that you run into with coding where you fix two things and break seven things, to have the community come together and do something like this, for me, I would be floored. I would probably be giving you guys a reaction video half crying as I unbox this stuff, especially that Kingpin, that amazing Kingpin. But that's, you know, that's me. I cannot speak for him and what his reaction will be to this, but I think I know Jason well enough at this point to know that he will be incredibly touched by this. And needless to say, this is not going to go out in the same box as this. This box is going in the trash, and I'm using another box with a few more layers of protection to prevent further damage. I have them wrapped in the bubble wrapped completely from base to head so that any force those things take in shipping that somehow gets through the box will impact more on the base, which is resilient, than potentially damaging any of the other figures over there. So, thanks everybody for checking out the video. If you were one of the donators, thank you. If you are one of the people who has always wanted to donate through a Patreon-style thing to Goofy in support of the project, do know that we have already proven that the community supports him in all of this, and that we have done something for him. And please enjoy the gesture to Goofy for all the hard work that he's doing on this project. So, this is Napalm Dawn signing out. Hope you like the figures, everybody. See ya.